Greetings, my fellow Earthlings. Tonight is a night of Chronos and Vegeta's. We're gonna try again. I tried this the other day and had some problems, but now we're gonna give it another shot. So for those that don't know what I'm talking about, tried to stream Chrono Trigger, ran into 1,000 technical problems, and I am currently streaming at 1 a.m. Eastern, which goes to show you, you can always predict when I'm gonna come on. Always. It might be 12, it might be 1. It's just really late, usually. So we're gonna check out the intro of my favorite game ever made, and then we're gonna stream it. I will impart on you much knowledge. This is the Super Nintendo version. I know a little bit about Chrono Trigger. I know a little bit about the story, so it'll be fun. Now let's just hope this time it works. Delicious Mode 7. I've done some research, and I figured out a number of reasons why it wasn't working last time, but I think this time it should be good. I'm gonna probably end up with my foot firmly planted in mouth, but we'll see what happens. You know, gosh darn it. Just wanna shoot some Chronos. And Bowsers. Yeah, sorry for streaming so late, guys. It's just, it's been one of those long days again, and I am... I'm here, finally, and I'm ready to play some Chrono Trigger. Okay, so this time everything's good. I have no schedule when it comes to streaming. It really is crazy. I mean, just expect me whenever. Just check the Twitter. I mean, usually around midnight, but your best bet is to just not have any expectation of a schedule of any kind. And sometimes I'll stream and sometimes I won't. But thank you for joining me on this lovely freezing Friday night, or if you like, Saturday morning here in the East Coast. 22 degrees. Yeah.
Chrono. Good morning, Chrono. It is me, Vegeta.
Come on, sleepyhead. Get up.
Aline's bell makes such beautiful music. You were so excited about the Millennial Fair that you didn't sleep well, did you? I want you to behave yourself today. Let's get moving now. So, I guess, I'll explain a little bit about the game, its history, but I'll explain my history with the game yet again. Since last time we did this, there were some pretty nasty issues. Finally, by the way, that inventor friend of yours, I've forgotten her name. Luca. That's right, Luca. Don't forget she invited you to see her new invention. Run along now, I'll be back before dinner. Here's your allowance, dear. 200G. Cat. Okay, so if you didn't see this the other night, I'm just gonna do this again. you know, as if I was in some sort of fucking Twilight Zone episode. The deja vu is intense. And not just because I've did this the other day, but also because I've played this game many times and have probably completed it almost over a dozen times, if not definitely over a dozen times. This was one of my once a year games that I played, and I would still say that this is my favorite game ever made. Okay, so combat is turn-based. This was, like I said, like the dream collaboration between Akira Toriyama and two other guys. The music was done by Yasunori Mitsuda, and Yamatsu actually stepped in when Mitsuda worked so hard on this game that he actually, like, physically injured himself. One of these bushes is legit. I just have to remember which one it is. I think this is it. No? Vinny, can you do a shout out against cancer? I just found out my father has cancer. It would make me feel better if it was from you, honestly. I'll dedicate this entire Chrono Trigger stream to the eventual cure of cancer, or at least preventative treatment, because fuck cancer. Alan Rickman, David Bowie, I mean, people that I know over the past few years. So yes, fuck cancer very much, and best of luck to you, Desert, and your family. So, I'm just gonna get a little experience points, just for no reason, just to maybe just kill a few minutes. So, yeah, Mitsuda worked so hard on the soundtrack that he, at one point, I think was hospitalized, and Yamatsu, who did the music for Final Fantasy, had to step in and complete a few tracks, and I don't remember which tracks exactly. If anyone has a link for me, so I can reference that link when we hit various songs, and I can tell you who composed, I can tell you when Yamatsu composed it. Also, there's a shelter in one of these bushes, but I don't think it's active right now. That might be a little bit later on. Vinny, do you have a P.O. box? So I can send you a game? Yeah, well, I don't give out the P.O. box unless you email me first. So just go to vinesauce.com, click contact, and you'll see my information. So. Alright. So yeah, this is the way the game is set up. And just go to Luca's house for a second. Luca's my inventor friend. Last time I streamed this game was like 2 years ago, and I streamed the DS version. Oh, hey, Chrono. Luca's off at Lean Square with her father, Tabin, unveiling her new invention. And since I showed this trick the other day, I can't not show it again. Just a little Easter egg kind of thing that I didn't know about until, God, my third or fourth playthrough. Also, you'll notice that I'm opening a double space stall at the fairgrounds. Always wanted to go to a 1000th anniversary. A festival, let's get crazy. Just, there's no point to that. It's just an endless amount of people crossing the bridge over and over and over again. The same people, clones, if you will, clones. So, we gotta get the story moving, because there's a lot of people in this chat who have not seen this game. So this is how the game starts. You're at a festival. One silver point. Yeah, one! Let's do a race, shall we? The race is on. Be quiet and watch. Okay, so we get to bet on one of these things. Last round's winner is G.I. Jogger. Guess the winner? Sure. Okay. Steel Runner, Green Ambler, Cadillac, or G.I. Jogger? The Green Ambler. Definitely. Always vote Green Ambler. Oh, hey, not so serious. What's up? Yeah, Green Ambler. I used to think that if you moved in front of the other runners, it would slow them down. I don't know if that's actually a thing or not. I just do it anyway. But yes, Green Ambler won. Traksuit. That's great. I'll put 20 silver points on your card. Yeah. Yeah. Alright, so then... Hey! Ouch, that hurt. I'm so sorry, are you okay? Uh-oh, my pendant. So, very important. Not really, but very important. Talk to her first. Oh no, don't tell me I lost it. Don't just grab the pendant. You gotta talk to her first. Oh, thank goodness, my pendant has a lot of sentimental value. May I have it back? Yes. I came to see the festival. You live in this town, don't you? I feel a little out of place here. Would you mind if I walked around with you for a while? Sure. You're a true gentleman. Oh, by the way, my name is, Marl and not Marley. Marl, and you're Chrono. What a nice name. Pleased to meet you. Now lead on. So, I don't know if I mentioned this the other day, but a lot of the stuff that happens here actually has a slight effect later on in the game. The way you treat Marl and some of your actions here. But you'll find that out later on. It's a soda guzzling contest. Press A as fast as you can. It's definitely soda and not alcoholic. You're awfully competitive, aren't you, Chrono?
Ha! Huh.
This is where they dance. Welcome to the dancing. Who cares? Who cares? Who gives a shit? I got other things to do at the fair. I'm a busy man. No time to talk, just sitting down for my lunch. I said this the other day, but if you watch, this old man will never sit down for his lunch. He forgot how to sit down. He really does not know how to sit. By the way, that's a pretty fucking sick pomp. Okay. I've probably returned this cat to its rightful owner more times than I've driven to New Jersey. Think about that for a second. And I live in the state right next to New Jersey. You brought back my cat! Thank you! You're so sweet, Chrono. So then the cat... You have to walk with the cat, otherwise the cat will run away. But, yeah, you just, you know, you do nice things for people, and it's, you know, it's good. It's good to do nice things, not because anything happens later on specifically.
Oh, Gonzales, oh, God, it's so yummy.
Sorry, it's just a cartoon. It's a cartoon. I'll show you in a bit. So, your position on the battlefield is important in regards to what moves can hit and what moves some of the enemies can hit you with. So, that's how the battle system works. It's all, like, there's no map transition like Final Fantasy. It's just right there. Okay.
Silver point! Oh!
I can't not hear this Japanese cartoon. Okay, so there's this little Japanese cartoon that has a few, like, misadventures of a few characters in Chrono Trigger. And I always enjoyed this, but here, I'll just show you this one segment of Gato coming to life. I call him Gato. I don't know if it's Gato or what, but check this out. There's a whole little anime thing. There's like, you know, it's fun. It's only a few minutes. It's worth watching. Just type Chrono Trigger anime and you can find It's just silly. It really doesn't have that many of the main characters, but you know, there's this frog. I mean, I like frogs. Do you like frogs? So if you like frogs, you might want to check it out. Just saying. Yeah, that was on the autopilot back in the day. Man, I love that. I love that video. So, yeah. I'm gonna beat up Gato one more time. So, I guess I have to answer for why is this my favorite game. It isn't my oh god, Chrono, please. It isn't my favorite game necessarily because of... Bye, Chrono. Because of the gameplay. So much as it's my favorite. No, the gameplay is good, but... I love the story, I love the music, I love the setting, I love the characters. This is like my favorite video game movie. Yeah, when Gato is near you, and you attack, he does counterattacks with the multiple punch thing that killed Chrono. I'm just an idiot, I let it happen, but I'm doing this for silver points, I'm not doing this for, experience. Okay, so I have some silver points now. I like to do this early on. Ha! Am I gonna grind for the load sword? Yeah, I mean, I mentioned Melchior, by the way. This guy's kind of important later on, but... Yeah, this- they changed the name of this to a different name. I forget what name they called it in the DS version, but yeah, it's called, Load? Load sword. In this one. Could you talk that young lady into selling her pendant? No. You never convince the young lady. You can have Chrono's mom meet the companions. My, how nice. I've only ever seen you with Luca, who's your pretty new friend. Hi, I'm Marl. Marl? I'm sure I've seen you before, dear. Now, where was that? Don't want to be rude, but is Vinny planning on doing more Conquer tonight? No. Tonight's just Chrono Trigger. Conquer will happen over the next, few days. It's... Yeah, you can save anywhere on the world map. I think even... You can even save... some other places, too. But, anyway. I heard Luca and her dad have made another crazy invention. Hope it doesn't blow up like all the others. They gotta be ready now. Make for the far side of the square. It's gonna be fun. Come on, Chrono. So, you actually have to explore the fair a little bit before you can, advance the story. It's the big deal. So what if we won a war against a wizard hundreds of years ago? This is the renowned Tent of Horror. Spend your 56 silver points here. Parental discretion advised. Welcome to Norstein Beckler's lab. The spine-tingling show is about to start. Oh. I gotta get more points. Oh, wait, no, it's only 40, I think, to do the thing that I need to do. Okay, hang on, let's do this. Let's see, I usually fuck this up. Let's see if I can do it on the first try. Left arm, right arm. A is surprise, Y is laugh. Okay. Let's see, here we go. Action. I have to mimic my clone. I didn't bind the button properly. I didn't fucking bind the button properly. You bastard. Okay, party foul. Oh, look at that! Oh, how did I get back there? Oh! Oh! Yeah, that is Kefka's laugh, by the way. There's some sound, they were developed around the same time, so some of the sound effects are the same, like the wind, a few other little things. The laugh. I'll still count this as my first one. Because the binding of the button being fucked up, that's not a... That's, oh my god. Got it. The clone will be at Chrono's house. Alright, so, I have my very own clone now. And you know the rest of that meme. So with the rest of my silver points, I could just... silver points for GP if I really wanted to. There's no real reason not to. I hate fairs. Say, do you know the latest gossip? No. Just between us, I heard that the king is distressed over his tomboy of a daughter. Just once I'd like to see how wild she really is. Hold your horses, I want to get some candy. There's a reason I'm not moving. You can, I'm just not. Hi, I'd like some of this. Sure, young lady. Thanks for waiting. Step right on up. Any of you have the time and courage, our super dimension warp is the invention of the century. To use it, jump up here. And you'll get to the teleport. You'll get teleported here. It's a masterwork of my beautiful daughter, Luca. I had a really good voice for him 2 years ago. I forget what it was, though. God damn it. Again, I should point out, this is the first game I ever streamed, ever. And therefore, it has a special place in Vinesauce history and in my own cold, rotten heart. Check out that girl's glasses. Give it a try, kid. Oh, it's you, Chrono. Chrono! Where have you been? No one wants to try the telepod. How about you? It looks like fun! I'll watch while you try it out. Okay, volunteer me for... Okay, if I die, then... How many people watched? Like, 5? Including Jen. Jen was at the very first stream. Hey, Hootie. Welcome to the stream. Yeah, Jen was at the very first, stream of this. Just hop onto the left pod. And what? Oh, that's it. I thought there was more. I thought she was gonna explain it. No, just go in blind. Don't even test the technology. Just... That's okay. I'll have my particles scattered for you, Luca. Don't worry about it.
Wow, that was great!
So how was it? Want to try it again?
It worked? I can't believe it! A thrilling display of science. At its best, ladies and gentlemen.
What a kick! I want to try it too. Huh? Hey, Chrono, how did you pick up a cutie like her? Hang on, Chrono. I'll be right there.
Behold, ladies and gentlemen, as this vision of loveliness steps aboard the machine.
Don't go away. I'll be right back.
You sure about this? There's still time to change your mind.
No way. Throw the switch.
Okay, everyone. Let's give her a great big hand when she reappears. All systems on.
Begin energy transfer. What's happening? My pendant, it's... Huh? You fucked up.
Luca, where is she?
Show's over, folks. Let's head along now.
What's going on, Luca? Where is she?
The way she disappeared, it couldn't have been the telepod. Warp field seemed to be affected by her pendant.
What are we gonna do now?
She's so familiar. I know I've seen her somewhere.
Why she disappeared? I couldn't be a telephone. What are we gonna do now? What are we gonna do now?
Chrono.
You're actually gonna do it?
What a fine lad. Listen, I don't know where this machine's gonna send you, but we haven't any other choice.
Won't they both be lost?
This is our only hope. The pendant seems to be the key, so hang on to it, Chrono, and brace yourself.
All systems on.
Begin energy transfer.
Sure, yeah.
Power to full.
Roger.
More.
Captain, we need more power. Roger. I cannot do it, Captain. I need more power.
There, we did it. I'll follow you after I know what went wrong. Good luck, Chrono! Get ready for some graphics. Oh my god.
Oh, I'm in a tunnel. Oh.
You have no idea how cool that was in 1995. I mean, if you wanted to grind for the load sword, you could do that. And by now you'd be, you know, killing imps even faster? Oh wait, no. No, you wouldn't, because they die in one hit. It comes in handy a little bit later if you get the load sword early, but it's, I don't know, it's not really worth it. Like, I like to grind in Secret of Mana a little bit early on and reach like level 5 or 6, but Chrono Trigger, there's kinda not a whole lot of times you need to do any real grinding. There is one particular time I grind for a weapon that is just broken. or not too broken, but let's just say for a little bit of grinding, like 20 minutes worth, you can get a weapon that's like not received for another 2 hours or so, or two or three hours, depending on how quick you are. And I usually get that one. I'll show you when that is. That's a good time. So, again, what I should have did was cycloned the green Rolly, and I would have gotten all three of them in one go, but I misclicked. Notice, this is the same spot on the map that I was when I went into Lean Square. Just here, it's called Truce Canyon.
Where am I? Are you stupid? This is the Kingdom of Guardia. We're battling Magus's army. You did know that, right?
Of course.
Then shut your pie hole! Well, in your fair, what? Are you crazy? What nonsense?
What a relief. They finally found Queen Lean wandering up in the mountains.
She must be glad to be home!
The Magus' army destroyed Xenon Bridge, so the South Continent is inaccessible.
Are you a stranger here too? I'm Tama the Explorer. If you're buying, I'll tell a story. How about it?
Sure.
Cider, please? Thanks. It's about the missing queen. She disappeared while visiting that cathedral to the west and... Beg your pardon, what? They found her? Oh, never mind. I was sure there was something fishy about that cathedral.
Everyone's a bogan in the past, that's right. There's a funny little glitch here I like.
I'm Bantai the blacksmith. I'm forging a bell for the king to present to his beloved Queen Lean. I lost it when the queen disappeared, but I just couldn't keep working on the bell. But now it's back to business as usual.
My husband wants a door who is intelligent as she is beautiful.
Watch this. If you try to run into Banta, he just goes fucking crazy. Depending on which angle you run into him, you could make him, like, beat the shit out of the bell. Yeah, these are implied to be Luca's, ancestors.
You're going to fight Magus's army? Wonderful, but remember to equip yourself with the weapons you buy.
No window shoppers, what do you want?
Mermaid.
Thanks, see ya. Like I said, it's not totally necessary to upgrade so quickly, but I think a helmet is a pretty good early upgrade. It's just one. It's cheap. It's worth it. Millennial Fair here? What are you talking about? It's the year 600. 21st King of Guardia reigns. I call it Guardia, like LaGuardia Airport. It's spelled the same way. People are like, no, it's Guardia. So if I call it Guardia, it's because that's just how I always said it.
We've been at war for years. When will it end?
So here's that forest again. Except this time, it's a little more dangerous. So again, if I use the cyclone attack, right in the middle. You get all of them, except the little motherfucker didn't die. His head is a green ass. He's like a little what is it? What's the green guy? Is it Krillin in Dragon Ball Z? I never really watched Dragon Ball Z. Who's the green guy? It's not Freezer, is it? Found one power tab. Power tab just gives you extra attack power permanently. It's Piccolo, right? Right, Piccolo's right. Piccolo dick, of course. There you go. How could I forget that? It's memes. So now I do 12 damage. I use that one right away. This is a trap, but it's experience, so I'll do it. So experience points, obviously, that increases your level. Tech points are, well, your skills, right? If I get 68 more, I get this next skill. I don't plan on getting maybe all the ultimate weapons. Yeah, you know what? I probably am gonna get all the ultimate weapons. Never mind. Ya boobay, ya boobay, ya boobay, ya boobay. That's for you, GPM. I know how much you enjoy, you know, birding it up. Monster dropped a shelter. You can just get a bunch of those. Yeah, let's ranch it up. You know, the trail of beers. That show is such trash, holy fuck. But I love it. I don't know why I love it. I feel wrong for watching the Eric Andre show, I really do, but there's just something about it that makes me laugh. Like, Mike summed it up best. He likes it when people act completely fucking stupid, but make it as if there's nothing wrong and it's completely normal. It's totally normal. I was like, you are actually, you hit the nail on the fucking head. So what's a shelter? A shelter is, you use it on the world map, and it's basically, for your, like, a tent in Final Fantasy. It restores your health and MP. Halt. Who goes there? Check out that hair. Where are you from, son? Are you one of Magus's troopers?
Oh, hardly. This kid, you'd never make the cut. Show us your stamp collection, son.
Now beat it, shrimp. Stop that at once. Queen Lean. Show your manners. This is a friend of mine.
But there's something odd about him.
You refuse to obey my direct orders.
Forgive me, lady. My lady, please enter, sir.
Giggle.
Magus' troops had better watch out for us.
I'm hungry.
Here's your food.
All right. This is great.
This dining room is for us soldiers. Feel free to grab a bite. So you saved Queen Lean. This place is a mini war zone.
This is no place for kids. Wait, maybe you know. What is this ice cream stuff that Queen Lean wants so badly? I fart in your general direction.
Where's supper? Oh, Captain, I'm sorry. We're fighting a war out there. Can't you even keep us fed?
What are you fussing about? You're not the only one who's fighting out there.
Hey, I don't have time for this. Just feed my men, okay?
It's like tripping over my words here.
Shut your trap. I'll decide who gets fed in vain.
Why are they eating a piece of log? It's a good question. What will you have? Hyper kebab. Just a sec, okay? There you go. HP and MP recovered. So, pretty clear. You know, I'm in the past. So this pendant threw me into the past. Well, threw Chrono into the past. This is, as you can see on the map, in the bottom left, 600 AD. You know, you're at 999 AD in when the game starts.
Sir, I understand that you are the one who saved my dear wife, the Queen. But can you tell me what happened? Lin's acting rather odd. She seems to have lost her coral pin, which is something she's guarded her whole life. Or guarded with her life, rather. Forgive me, you must be tired. We can talk about this later. Please rest in the knight's quarters, downstairs to the left.
King's room is upstairs, the knight's quarters are downstairs to the left. These are important later on.
What do you want? Get out of my face!
Just between us, the Chancellor's been acting very strange lately. He's been sneaking out at night. Speaking of nutcases, I haven't seen the Queen's Guard, that frog thing, recently. Heard a spell turned him into a frog. You believe that? I think he's a spy.
People say the Chancellor's gone crazy, but I don't believe it. The Chancellor's a decent man. Why, he goes to the cathedral every day. Correct me if I'm wrong, but isn't there five different side quests you need for the rainbow weapon? Much later on, yeah, there's quite a few side quests at the end of this game that are required to get the best weapon for Chrono. It's, yeah, it's a little bit of a process to get some of the best weapons in the game. He's a good God-fearing man, that Chancellor. He's an alright guy. I like his mustache too. The Queen awaits. The Queen married into the family 10 years ago. She still looks so youthful. In fact, she looks even younger now than on her wedding day. Yeah, I'm not about the Queen right now, I'm about the Aether. Alright. Peace! Oh, fine. My conscience kicked in. You saved our Queen? You don't look that tough. Ah, there you are. Please leave us, I need to talk to this individual. Certainly, Your Highness. Come nearer, sir. Fooled you, didn't I, Chrono? It's me, but everyone keeps calling me Lin. I'm so relieved you're here. We barely know each other, but somehow I knew you'd come for me. Thank you, Chrono. Something's wrong. What's happening? It feels like I'm being torn apart. Help me, Chrono! I'm scared. Please, Chrono. Alright. Can I sleep in the bed? It's my chambers now. I get to drink this flagon of wine. I get to work this machine here. And I get to sleep in the royal bed. What a boring fucking existence this must have been. You have a grand total of chair, wine, bed, and sewing machine. So, I'm to understand that you're to get pissed off of wine, like get like drunk off your head and go to sleep, or get like totally smashed and like, I don't know, fucking do this thing. What is this, a thing? What is the wheel again? What does it do? Oh, who gives a shit? Or sit. And maybe chest, if you're interested in like throwing something in the chest, but it's just a boring life. Has she dismissed you already? You were polite, of course. You didn't do anything funny, did you? Well, yes. Ooh, we can't let this juicy tidbit out of the castle. Did you notice anything odd about the queen? Yes. Just as I thought, she claims she's not lean. There's something different about her. Don't mention this to anyone. The spinning wheel, it's a loom, right? It spins and it makes thread from wool. Thank you. Thank you. Chrono!
You're okay.
Did you find the girl?
Gone? What do you mean she's gone?
It's just as I thought. I knew I recognized her. And this looks identical to the castle in our time. I'll bet they mistook that girl for her ancestor. You see, she's a member of the royal family in our time. She's Princess Nadia. Marl, that is Princess Nadia, or Nadia, I say, is a descendant of Queen Lean. Queen Lean has been kidnapped. As I recall, someone was supposed to have saved her, but history has been changed. Mar looks so much like Lean that they probably called off the search when she appeared here. But if the real queen is killed... Mar will simply disappear. There might still be time. If we can save Lean, history as we know it should remain unchanged. Something must have happened to the queen in this era. As a result, Princess Nadia ceases to exist. Hurry, we have to find the real queen. Same dialogue. Seen in Bridge is our last line of defense. We must guard it with our lives. They're the ones who helped the queen. Talk to the maid if you need to rest. Oh, if only Sir Cyrus were here. You've heard of him, haven't you?
No.
You don't know of Sir Cyrus? From which land do you come? Or are you simply a fool? Oh, whoops. Magus's troops are strangely quiet. Something's about to happen. So Luca is here. Luca has a gun. You know, in the year 9999, that's, you know, guns are pretty standard weaponry by then. Of course, no one in the medieval ages questions that she has a gun. They just think it's like wizardry, I suppose. Shelter. Those are free. You could just keep farming those if you really want to. it actually is kind of worth it early on to get like, three or four of them. I'll get one more, actually. And the thing is, you can do that without even having to fight a battle. So you can just really just keep doing this over and over and over again. Oh, I lied. I think I was too close to the tree. Whoops. Whoops. One sec. Okay, I'm back. By the way, sectoids can rub their own scrotum until it's raw. In XCOM 2. Just saying. Oh, no. Stun Lancers are even worse, though. Seriously, fuck Stun Lancers. I don't need one of my soldiers unconscious throughout a whole mission, and then I have to bring that soldier to the drop zone, to the extraction zone later on. Essentially, one Stun Lancer can remove two of my soldiers for an entire battle in XCOM 2. This bridge is being fixed because Magus's army thrashed it. But until Sir Cyrus returns, we'll fight Magus's army tooth and nail! We want nothing but world peace. Or a piece of the world. Nope, fuck this place, I'm out. It was never one for religion. Wait, what's this? A dart gun is available in the Middle Ages. Hmm. 1337G. I'm gonna end up getting all that stuff anyway, so... I was considering buying something, but I don't really think I need to. You might like to stick around for the organ recital. It's a real killer! People wouldn't know what to do with themselves in a world truly peaceful. Oh my, what delicious... delightful-looking humans! Mm-mm. These are normal nuns! We're just normal nuns! Oh dear, it looks like you could use some food and a place to rest. What did you find? A hairpin. That's Guardia's royal crest. Wow. Also, look closely and you'll see they're wearing blue bikinis. Human music! No, actually, you got that wrong. A medieval dart gun is more powerful than a gun made 400 years later by a brilliant inventor. So that dart gun is actually more powerful. Okay, there's another one down.
Garbage. Garbage pistol.
I'll say this, though, for grinding and getting some better weapons early. It makes this go a lot faster. Yeah, but it doesn't... The thing is, when you buy the dart gun, it doesn't look like a crossbow. It looks like a gun when Luca holds it. And here's the other thing about it. Later on, you can buy more medieval guns. It's just never explained. It doesn't need to be. It's a video game, but it still kind of makes me laugh a little bit. Who's my favorite Goku in this game? Chrono. There we go. Now I got some better skills. That was close.
Ack!
Lower thine guard and thou art allowing the enemy in. Thou art here to save the queen? The lair is deep within. Will thee accompany me?
A frog? Chrono, it's a talking frog! I hate frogs.
My guise doth not incur thy trust. Very well. Do as thee please, but I shall save the queen.
Wait. You don't seem like a bad, person, frog thing. I mean... Chrono, what should we do?
I'll just have to handle it. I mean, deal with him.
What's your name?
No, I'm not naming the frog Pepe. Okay? Here, I'll do it here, just so you guys can see.
See? So he was named Pepe very briefly, but I'm sticking with Frog.
Frog will do.
Alright. Nice to meet you, Frog.
Mayhap a hidden door lurks nigh. Let us search the environs.
In the DS version, they got rid of the medieval accent for Frog, since he's the only one in all of in the medieval era that has the inflection. The affectation, or whatever.
I'm leaving the names. It's not that I'm bland, it's just I'm not gonna meme with Pepe. I like leaving the characters named as they are.
That's what the developers named them.
And it's just better that way. I'd rather not have to call, you know, Chrono Mark because someone wants me to name them Mark, you know?
Trust me, you will come to understand this decision in time.
It's for your own good, you fuck.
This is the first track composed by Yamatsu. That one? It's crazy because that's probably one of my top three tracks. I found out that some of my favorite songs in this game were actually composed by Yamatsu. I remember, speaking of naming characters, someone in chat- No, you have to play like every middle schooler and name the main character yourself and the girl, as that girl who you liked but never even talked to, Slingblade, just said, true story, when I first played Secret of Mana, my cousin
who was older than me, was dating someone named Chrissy. And so we started the game. He was so in love with Chrissy. You know, it was gonna last forever. And, well, they broke up while we were still playing the game. So, that was a little awkward returning to the game. You know, we're doing co-op. He had to be reminded of her every single time we played the game. I didn't realize how great that was until later on in life. But, yeah, it's a true story. Vinesauce, did you cuck your friend? That was my cousin, and he was 9 years older than me. I was 8. Amazing. good listening skills.
Hey, what's with the disguise? No need for them here.
It's almost my shift. I hate pretending to be human. It's so repulsive.
Ones we ate recently weren't so bad. Those two soldiers we caught look rather plump and juicy.
Yakwa is so smart. His plan to capture the Chancellor and take his place worked perfectly. Now the Queen's captive and the castle's in an uproar. This is rich! Now look in on the mega statue before my shift.
They're happy monsters.
You here to save Queen Lean? Oh, what a relief.
How nice of you to come. I'm sure Yakra will be just as pleased. Why not rest here until he's available?
There's no need for you to come rescue me. The Master Yakra is very kind. I've decided to stay here. Now, why don't you make yourselves at home too?
Oh, dearest Magus, your flashing eyes like stars, flowing hair like waves atop the sea. No sad sunny day, nor any frightful bright place can get us down. As long as you're near, there's nothing to fear.
Don't know why Mario is singing it.
Magus, oh Magus, our hero Magus.
I call him Magus because it makes me think of maggots, right? And I just been pronouncing it Magus since I was a kid. Some people say Magus. I ain't about that. So, you're gonna have to deal, sorry. I love the Magus song.
Come join us in singing your funeral dirge.
Because when I look at Magus's face, I think of maggots. Because he's all like pale and maggoty. You know what I mean? So Magus. Magus. Magusta. You want me to pronounce it like that? Sure. It's pronounced Magus in Latin. Magus means wizard, Vinny. Okay. So, I'll just go ahead and stick with it. Fucking Frog. Frog is such a cool character. Look at him, he's wielding a broadsword. And look how happy he is when he wins a battle. He's just... I mean, he's so cool. He's a frog. He's in a cloak. So, here he is. Supreme Lord Magus. He's a wonderful human. Jabba, you're a wonderful human being. Belongs in a museum. The bandana grants plus one speed. This grants plus two speed. So there's really no reason not to put that on Chrono. The other two I like to leave. Don't be in such a hurry. Enjoy yourselves first. Snakes. So this is a double tech. It uses two characters' moves. And it does pretty fucking massive damage. But yeah, double techs use two character moves. And they are, you know, dependent on the character. Some characters work well with each other. And it's a cool, unique mechanic of the game. And then you can actually get triple techs later on. In which three characters can do a move together. Found the secret Naga et Bromide.
Hey everyone, humans! The rest of the Bromide!
Get him!
What the fuck is a bromide? Is it a bra?
Uh-oh.
So I learned some new moves. Maiden suit. Tonic. Ether. It's a chemical. No? Is it an element? I don't know what the fuck it is. A compound containing bromine ions. What the fuck? What does that have to do with the game, man? I don't know. So, get that on there. A bromide is a pinup picture? Oh. Wait, so it's like a nude? Did I just find a nude? You're humans? They're hiding the queen in the back. Please rescue her. Inside this building, there's a room dedicated to Magus. There's something about a treasure there. You know, that one line of dialogue, I heard something about a treasure there when I was a kid. I searched that room back and forth over and over again for like 20 minutes looking for what might have been an extra treasure. It turns out it's just two treasure chests. But I thought maybe if I touch every inch of this room, I'll find something hidden. Be a fire whirl. Luca's speed is so fucking slow. Oh, that's fucking wonderful. Before they even get a chance to attack. Free experience. So this is a good time to use a shelter. So I'm gonna take a quick moment. I need to have a piss. Like, have a piss, not take one, have one. I'll be right back, guys. Give me a few minutes. Enjoy the music. I'll see you in a minute. Bad news, everyone. It's split into two streams. I tried so hard to keep them together. Shit. I've been told, the Ghostbusters told me not to cross the streams, I know. But they also said that busting makes them feel good. Someone in chat just said, Vinny, I just finished Star Trek The Next Generation. What Star Trek show should I move on to next? Go to Deep Space Nine next. Really well-written show. Early on, it kind of tries a little too hard to be like TNG. But when it gets its own sense of identity, it's maybe some of the best Star Trek ever. So, Deep Space Nine is a very high recommendation. Just stick with it, though. It gets better. You know, first two seasons, three seasons, you're gonna be like, ah. But some classic, amazing episodes a little bit later on. Skull switches. Yeah, skull switches. No entry. No shit, it's a wall. Got a heal and a tonic. I like how that skull switch just summons more fucking bats. Thank you, Waspy. Also, someone donated 5 cents. That happens from time to time. Some huckster tries to donate 5 cents to see if I have one of those auto donation readers. Or just to, like, be a penis. But the good news is, Bazooka Joe has not gone up in price, my friend. So the joke is on you, because you just got me some Bazooka Joe. Thank you so much for the donation. I'm gonna put it towards saving the animals. We rich now, motherfucker!
No, stop it. I said you can't.
Huh?
I'll say this, you know what you're doing.
I never understood that line. I never understood that line. That probably was changed in the DS version. What if it's really all they could afford, Vine Sauce? Well, the thing is, I actually very, very highly discourage donations. You know, so... I would say don't donate. If that's all they could afford, then I would say, man, how are you even watching the stream? Like, what manner of phone or internet or computer are you on? I think we need a new substitute for the word potato, like when people say potato camera or potato internet. Or potato quality. We need something else. We need, like, a new... Potatoes, you know, are great. So, we need something different. What if he's currently on a... Oh, man. I can't even think of anything. Tomato? Toaster? Yeah, toasters are pretty... We use those, too. A foot camera. Nickel quality. Lemons. Frog quality. Vinny quality, there you go. Betamax quality, that's interesting.
Trash.
Roasted hazelnut. Werewolves. So he's on a werewolves, like, computer right now, watching this on his internet that has a down speed of 13 kilobytes per year. So yeah, I mean, it's cool all around, really. Vine Sauce chat quality. Okay. Says the member of the Vine Sauce chat. So, someone in chat just said they got a pop-up from solving the captcha on the Buru. I'd like to let you know if anyone else gets that. I have no idea why that is. I have nothing to do with that. We do not really control the Buru. It's a thing that's used... Hold on, just three of them came out? It's a thing that we use, that we've been able to customize, but we still don't really have full control over it. So if there is... If there is an ad, or something like that, turn your ad block on or something. I don't know, sorry. McDonald's quality? Well, I gotta say, fucking McDonald's has really good coffee. What is that? Why do they have good coffee? That's right, Fred. Bulba. Pink hair Bulba. I don't like their fries very much. I really don't like- I don't like much of McDonald's food, but their coffee is pretty good. they own their own coffee? Oh. Someone in chat just said it's fried roaches, not coffee. Someone in chat also said, I mean, it's not hard to get good coffee. You'd be surprised. Since I've become a bit of a coffee person, I have to say, I've had some really, really shit coffee. There's this deli coffee that people have been doing, like, cups that say savor or savor. I make fun of it now because I just hate it. And it was like this disgusting burnt, like, ass AIDS roast. And, I mean, it wasn't like, you know, fast food. It was like a deli's own brand or whatever. And it was really bad. And then the next day, I went to, the next day I went to McDonald's and I was like, why is this 100% better? I kind of want coffee too now, but it's 2:30 a.m. There's no time for coffee. This is not the time for coffee. You know that, I know that. Unless you're in Australia or something, in which case, or you're in England and it's really early, then you're good. You know, enjoy.
Prepare yourself, Queen Lean. You! How did you get in here?
Frog! Majesty, stand back and allow us the honor!
Be careful.
It's useless to fight! No one will leave here alive! Ah, stupid frog! It's time for you! You jumped off this mortal coil! True form change!
Reverts to Yakra. This whole time, who would have thought? Anyway, we have a really good double tech. Frog and Chrono. So this is, I'm not really sure what I'm looking at when I look at Yakra. It's a big bug with ram horns, maybe? Is it happy? I can't tell. It looks happy. Oh god, what does it want? Does it want food? Yeah, X slash is great. It's such a to me, it's such an iconic part of this game. Crotch crab? Okay. Got it. Someone said it's a crotch crab. I mean, the first few bosses aren't too, you know, involved. It's just keep your HP kind of high. And just keep attacking. There you go. One, 50 experience, 5 tech points, Chrono's levels up, Hypno Wave. Combine that with Frog and you get Hypno Toad. You came to rescue me, thank you, Frog. Well, got a few other donations since I mentioned that last one, and this one is for 3 cents. And then, yeah, another one for 10 bucks, but please, thank you. But I'm not gonna read it out because I don't want to encourage people to donate. Do not donate. I do not need donations. go donate to a charity instead.
You came to rescue me. Thank you, Frog.
The king awaits. Let us return to the castle. I thank thee, Chrono and Luca.
Yes, thank you so much. Please join us. $10 person, though. I do appreciate it. Thank you. I don't know what I'll buy. I'll buy, a McBag Bomb.
Thank you. That monster stuffed me in there. Oh, your highness. As you can see, I am undamaged.
It's like a C-3PO character.
Let's return to the castle.
I like how the Chancellor was able to survive inside of an airtight treasure chest for God knows how long.
You had me worried, Lean.
Oh, that no good Yakra impersonating me and kidnapping the Queen. We must create a criminal justice system in this kingdom to do away with such fiends.
I failed to protect Queen Lean. I have disgraced thee.
Frog.
That no good Yakra impersonating me and kidnapping the queen?
The timing was perfect. Who knows what would have happened had you not saved me. By the way, where is the girl who was mistaken for me? Oh yeah, I forgot all about Princess Nadia. Chrono, where did Princess Nadia disappear? She may still be there.
Thank you, Chrono, but who was that girl we found in the canyon? It was a fault of mine, which endangered the queen. I shall depart for good. Chrono, you have potential to be a good swordsman.
Goodbye, Froggy. You will be missed. Froggy, you weren't such a bad guy either.
Isn't it amazing how time stuff works?
It's like clockwork, she's back. Get it?
'Cause time. I didn't realize I made a pun until after I said it.
Wow. I'm actually disappointed in myself.
Huh?
What happened? Princess Nadia. Chrono. It was awful. I can't recall it at all. It was somewhere cold, dark, and lonely. Is that what it's like to die? Welcome back, Princess Nadia. You risked your life to help me, too? Princess Nadia? Uh-oh. I guess you guys figured it out, huh? Sorry, Chrono, I didn't mean to deceive you. I'm Princess Nadia. My father's King Guardia the 33rd. I really enjoyed being with you at the fair, but if you had known my identity... Chrono, you would have... Wouldn't... Chrono, you wouldn't have shown me around the fair, right?
Wrong.
Ah, Chrono, that's why I like you. The real queen's safe, right? So let's go home, Chrono. You guys leaving? Wherever you're heading, be careful. Which means the real Lean was somewhere else. It's exactly as I thought. They're not upset about this imposter.
The more I look at you, the stronger the resemblance. Uncanny!
You're the wheel... Queen Ween, huh? really could be my twin. Well, you two better get along, or I'll be in big trouble. I'll keep my fingers crossed. Excuse me? Never mind, I guess it's time to go. Thank goodness you're safe. You may resemble Lean, but you sure don't act like her. Anyway, you've really helped me. Let me know how I can repay you. I wonder if the king, like, was so happy that his wife came back that they, like, had sex with her? Oh my god, could you imagine? Yo, is the king a two-pump chump? Oh no! I had never arrived at this conclusion. I really hope I'm wrong. Ancestrophilia? Is that what you'd call it? Cross-generational incest. Holy fuck. Oh, this is a new fetish just waiting to be born. Oh no, what have we done? Oh no, 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 we created a new fetish. Oh god. Can we takesy backsy? Is there takesy backsies on this? And then someone in chat just said, we all know the Chancellor is Marl's real ancestor. The king is getting cucked. I'm not even a huge fan of the cuck meme. It's just such a fun word to say and look at. It's the word itself that makes it fun. It's so stupid. It really is. And it's, again, used totally wrong, like, a good half of the time it's used. But it still makes me laugh because of how funny the word is. Oh gosh, I got a tear in my eye from that. Jesus Christ. I could be a slightly less of a cheap bastard. Even though I really probably just wasted the money. So anyway, we've saved the queen. And we've restored the timeline. And now the game is over. Thank you for watching. That's Chrono Trigger. And that's why it's my favorite game of all time. We rescued the princess. And we're done. This is just the epilogue. Where they go home. And Chrono can't choose between the two as to which one he loves more. So they start a commune, right? And they add more people to the commune eventually, men and women. And then, you know, it starts a new thing, and then the future becomes a whole lot more kinky. How do we get home? Your highness, princess, please, call me Marl. Well then, Marl, observe! Wow! Luca, you're amazing! Ain't it the truth? Enough with the false modesty. You have a real gift. I would trade my royal ancestry for your genius in a heartbeat. Well, if you say so. Anyway, I call this thing a gate. It's a kind of portal that takes you to the same location in a different era. Gates are very unstable, so I use the principle behind my telepod device to create a gate key. Now we can use them as we please. But why did this gate suddenly appear? Either the telepod had something to do with it, or something else made it. This is getting pretty weird. Let's at least head back to our own time. Alright. Coming, Chrono? Chrono came... nothing. Huh! We're back. Chrono, Luca, why don't you come home with me to the castle? I'd like you to come over for dinner. Sorry for putting you through all that, Marl. Are you joking? That's the most fun I've had in months. I have some new friends, too. Chrono, be a gentleman and take her home. I've got some work to do. See you soon, Luca. Will you escort me home, Chrono? How tasty do you find the music in this game? Don't you dare. Put a dollar in the tasty jar. You are not allowed to compare music to food. I've learned this from a wise producer named Joe. We still say it every now and then, and he still gets really angry. You're not allowed to say that something is tasty if it's music. That's just beans. Hello, Chrono. Hello, Chrono!
Hello, Chrono!
Yeah, clone. Yeah. Studying. Me and Marl can go off and do immature things. And, like, the mom will think Chrono's home, studying. And, like, I could see the mom, like, coming upstairs. Oh, hello, Chrono. What are you working on today? Well, you don't talk much anyway, so I guess never mind. Seriously, there's no difference. Put Chrono in the bed, the Chrono clone in the bed, and the mother will not be able to tell the difference. There's just no way. We're back. Two-legged walking humanoid robots are virtually impossible to create. Even though you did create one named Gato or Gato that's at the fair. Oh, Chrono, hurry up and escort the princess to the castle. I mean, granted, he's the easiest piece of shit enemy in the game, but I still lost a character to him. So, I did this when, the stream crashed the other night. You know, when the game crashed. So, I'll just do it again real quick, just for anyone who missed it, to see what's over here. This is Poor. That's the name of the town. And they have a market. And there's some stuff here.
A bunch of shite, aye.
Some monsters coexist with humans, like that piano player.
Everyone's over at the festival. What fools!
And piano man.
Something upbeat. That's right. You can play drums on a keyboard. Got the best jerky in town, but I'm saving it. Might let some go for, say, 9900G. How about it? No. Didn't think so. Children are slipping away from us. It's so sad.
I run this town. I'm so rich, I don't know what to do with it all. Hey, give you 10G if you act like a chicken.
Yes. Chrono Chicken.
Wow. Here you go, Tenji.
Dad loves money more than he loves me.
Person I hate most, my dad, of course. Everyone says daddy's greedy. They're lying, right? No, your daddy's a piece of shit. Your daddy is what... Your daddy is what I'd call a twat. That's right. Even his face looks like the open labia of a twat vagina. That's right. I just said that. That's been said. Or as they would say in Conker's Bad Fur Day, a twatting shite.
I may have gone too far in a few places, but we can diminish the effect of it.
So let's go have dinner with Marl's family. What do you say? I'm a hero. I saved her.
Princess Nadia! Are you alright? Where have you been? I heard you were abducted. We had soldiers searching for you. Scoundrel! You're the one, huh? Kidnapping Princess Nadia?
No. Kronos...
Admit it! You confused her and tried to take over the throne! Terrorist!
Stop it!
Stop this at once! What are you doing?
But Princess Nadia said to...
Idiots! Detain him!
Chrono! Beautiful sprite work. Beautiful 16-bit art, rather.
I'm the Chancellor, the Prosecutor.
I'm the lawyer, Pierre.
Members of the court, we now bring forth the defendant, Chrono, who is charged with abducting Princess Nadia.
I go back and forth between Nadia and Nadia, and I don't know why, and I can't help it. God save me.
What shall we do with him? Fire, perhaps? Perhaps. Hang him upside down for a few years, or shall we employ the guillotine? You, the jury, shall decide his fate. Now, let us begin!
Are you... Chrono, you are hereby ordered to tell the truth.
Chrono is charged with premeditated abduction of royalty. The question is, did he kidnap Princess Nadia? The answer? No, he did not. In fact, no abduction took place. The two met completely by accident. In fact, the princess asked Chrono if she could join him.
Is this true? Who actually started this whole mess?
I forgot the answer you're supposed to do here, actually. Is it me or Marl? Is there a right answer to this one? I think it's... I did. Well, I mean, there's no good answer, but I'm just trying to do all the things right, just for fun. I did.
Just as I suspected, the defendant deliberately tried to get near the princess.
I'm going full honesty. Hey. Ouch, that hurt. The
princess then innocently followed you to Luca's little sideshow. Whereupon you both disappeared. If that wasn't criminal abduction, I don't know what is. And I have facts that throw the defendant's character into question. Objection. This can't have any relevance whatsoever to this case.
Care to respond, Chancellor?
Kronos' character is at the very core of this case. We have nothing to hide. We have a witness, a little girl who will vouch for the character of the defendant.
This nice man, he brought me my kitty. Thank you for being so kind.
How about that? Doesn't this young man deserve a medal? Whew, looks like they're buying it. The issue here is motive. Was there any motive for this fine citizen to kidnap Princess Nadia?
No, there was none.
What about ransom? Chrono, her fortune did tempt you, did it not?
No.
Are you sure you really weren't tempted?
Not at all.
That's enough. I have no more questions.
It is evident that my client is a fine, noble young man. Your Honor, the defense rests. Now, if you do other things, if you eat the old man's lunch, if you, do the thing with the candy wrong, like, for example, if you try to, like, stop her from buying candy, if you try to convince her to sell her pendant, then more people will come forward and try to say that Chrono's a shithead.
Members of the jury, if he is guilty, stand to the left. If innocent, stand to the right.
Not guilty. All right, if you get the pendant first, if you talk to her first, then you're good. You know, I've actually did this trial, I think, a few times where I got all not guilty.
All but one. Maybe. Yeah, all but one. One asshole.
A verdict has been reached. The verdict is not guilty. But the fact remains that even if he did not kidnap her, he ran off with her. 3 days solitary confinement as punishment.
Take him away!
Now, just a darn minute.
Princess!
That's enough, my dear.
But, Father, all I asked for was for you to behave like a princess. Even royalty must obey rules. Leave the rest up to the Chancellor and forget about the events in town.
We're leaving. Chrono. If you're found guilty, you're sentenced to execution. But...
This terrorist has tried to overthrow our kingdom. He has been found guilty, and you must now carry out his sentence.
So this is the monster who kidnapped the princess.
The execution is 3 days away. Do not let him out of your sight.
Execution? Strange, but I don't seem to recall hearing anything about an execution.
What? How dare you question me? The paperwork's probably just been held up in the system.
Understood, sir. Guards. Just medieval knights wearing full suits of plate armor. It's like, what?
Take the prisoner away!
Yeah, the Chancellor's a scumbag. Yep. So even if you're not guilty, you're still getting sentenced to execution in 3 days. He's a piece of shit. Some sympathizers have brought that stuff for you, you lousy felon. I'm sorry, I did that voice wrong. Got one ether. I think, if you do, depending on your guilt level, you get different items. Like, an ether, I think, is a good one to get. Otherwise, you'll get, like, a tonic or something shittier. This is how I should be doing it.
Pipe down. Pipe down! Knock it off! Oh, I'll show him. Open it up! That's what you get for misbehaving.
I love this escape, because look how slow he walks out. He's so pleased with himself. They didn't even take my fucking sword away. These guys suck.
Where do you think you're going?
Like, no one taught them how to do this job the right way. Like, they fight with... Those are enemies, by the way, but you can just walk between them, as you've just seen. They fight with the prisoner. They let the prisoner... They open up, you know, the door for the prisoner. They leave the prisoner's weapons. They walk slowly out of the cell with their back turned away from the prisoner. It's like towards the prisoner. They're back toward, yes, that's how you say that. Back turned toward the prisoner. They're just rubbish, basically. But that's what you get when you hire comedy knights in full plate mail from medieval times to be your fucking to be your guards. Also, not gonna lie, when I was younger, I was 10 when this game came out. I played it, you know, when I was 10, 11. That part right there kind of spooked me a little bit. Only a little, but it's definitely a spoop. A good spoop. I mean, I could fight them for experience, but they're a pain in the ass. The prisoner is escaping. Yes, also, if you don't do anything for the 3 days before the execution, Luca will break you out. Again, looked really, really cool in 1995. All these graphics. Okay, so this is actually, like, a kind of a stealth section. If you knock the guards out before they see you, you can, actually grab some of their items. Or grab some items you might not normally get without having to fight them. Mid-tonic. Those are pretty good to have right now, too. Help me! Nah. if you save him later on in the game, he becomes a boss, an undead catheter. So, by not saving him, later on in the game, you get access to one of the coolest and best items in the game. The, Obsidian Squeegee. And with the Obsidian Squeegee, you can eventually unlock the Mesopotamian landmine. But first, you have to... You can't get him, because you don't want him to turn into a ghost. So... yeah. Sorry. All right, fine. You're a lifesaver. I'm Fritz. My dad runs a store in Truce Village. Stop by if you're in the area. Those totally don't sound like completely made up items. What, the Obsidian Squeegee? You never heard about it? It's in the game. You're not supposed to rescue Fritz. What was the other one? The Mesopotamian landmine? Yeah, no, that's a really good one too. Okay, that guy doesn't have an item. There is a mop in this game. I don't know how to get it. So you're the escaped con. I remember there was a guide I had that showed the weakest weapon being the mop. And I was like, what the fuck? You start with the wood sword. Why would you get a mop? Where would you get a mop? And I remember looking for the mop and never finding it. You have to charm it off of a new. Oh. There you go. Oh, motherfucker. You are a motherfucker. I almost game over.
They don't pay me enough for this.
You know, before I do any of the voice acting, I have to have the inspiration. You know, I have to look at the character and really get inside the character's head and think to myself, like, what would this character sound like? You know, based on the design of the character. It's kind of a thing I do. You know, and I really put a lot of effort and thought into what my characters would sound like. And that guy just sounded like that to me. Like a real jabroni. You gotta get inside the animal's gourd. Information is inside the computer. I'm not gonna lie, I'm kind of, I wouldn't say excited for Zoolander 2, but I am. I think it could be good. It looks like it's gonna be good.
I think Ben Stiller has it in him to make a good sequel. I mean, I really do think that. There was a promo clip where Kristen Wiig was doing like a parody of some fashion lady, and her accent made absolutely no sense. Zoolander 2 has very low ratings, 22% on Rotten Tomatoes. Well, my foot is firmly planted in my mouth. That sucks. Never mind. All I know is I really enjoyed the fuck out of Kristen Wiig butchering words.
What if I told you the only reason I liked Zoolander 1 is because David Duchovny is in it?
Nah, Zoolander wasn't all that amazing of a movie, but it was dumb fun. Some cheap laughs, the gasoline fight. You know, Bowie's in it. Yeah, I mean, that's plus 10. Hang on a second. I want to see if I can get this lady's accent. It's amazing. Kristen Wiig. That's really disappointing. It's a shame. It sucked.
Welcome to the House of 8000 Booty Labia, Tori. Inside our state-of-the-art labia are many cocks. Talking of special lotions, you can be our man.
She's trying to say laboratory, and she's saying labia, a Tori.
House booty labia, Tori. Inside our state-of-the-art labia are many cocks. Cooking up special lotions you can pump all over your face. Booty is not easy. It takes hard work from scientists. Is your skin dry and cracked? Make it wet and shiny. Youth milk absorbs into the skin like water into a sponge. We have high
vegetables
from desert flower cactus. Distilled water from natural street puddles in Indonesia.
I don't know what it is about butchering words in a foreign accent that makes me laugh so hard, but I really, really like this.
What if you could turn back time and be baby again, but not by so stupid? Because when you look old, you feel sad. When you look young, you feel happy. Moisturizing costs money, but silk is free. I only use youth milk. I have no fillers, Botox, or surgeries. Radiance, effervescence, radishes, pastes. House of 8000,
yours. Good words.
Let's get wild.
Good words. Good words. I don't know why the fucking audio on that video was so low. That was the lowest video on YouTube. The fucking dripping noises in Chrono Trigger were louder. Were louder than that. You know, the sad thing is that that clip is probably going to be better than the entirety of Zoolander 2. Yeah, let's get crazy. Yeah. I can't wait to see Owen Wilson doing his voice again. Yes. Oh, yeah. Wow. Wow. Yeah. I actually really like Owen Wilson. I love his work with Wes Anderson. Wes Anderson. Darjeeling Limited is such a good movie. There's a lot of good Wes Anderson movies, but
but I particular enjoy our Darjeeling Limited.
Why does this castle employ blobs with shields? I don't know, but your name... someone in chat named Bewilderment just said, why do the castle employ blobs with shields? That is the perfect name for that question.
The prisoner is escaping!
Yeah, wow!
You like the Kinks, Vinny? I think the Kinks are one of the best bands from the 60s. Well into the 70s. They were great. Yeah, the Kinks are one of my favorite bands. Totally underrated in the US, too.
Help!
Chrono, I've come to save you. Ah, gee, it looks like you didn't need my help after all. Let's blow this joint. How the fuck did she get past all the guards in the front? A top secret document has been left behind the floor. Care to read it? To the prison supervisor, Dragon Tank Owner's Manual. The tank head repairs body damage. It contains a shield that prevents damage by lightning and fire. Unless the head can be defeated, the tank is unbeatable. That's one way to do a tip for the next boss. Someone in chat just said, are there any bands that were popular from the 60s to 70s that people don't remember today that you like? Big Star is my number one favorite band that not enough people know about. There's a documentary on them. Type Big Star documentary. It's on Netflix. Watch it. Listen to their albums. There's only three of them. Three of the best albums from the 70s, I think, ever. So yes, listen to Big Star. You know the theme to that 70s show? Hanging out! That was, a Big Star song covered by... I can't think of the band. Covered by... Cheap Trick, I think.
Forward, Dragon Tank! Crush those rebels!
Yeah, the song 13 is really good. 13 is, it's been covered by Wilco, Elliot Smith, and a lot of other people. It's just a very, very, very good song. So. Oh, shit. I mean, what kind of cheek do you have to build a tank in the shape of a dragon? In the modern age, where robots and, like, technology is happening for the first time, and you have to make it look like a dragon. I mean... come on, really? So yeah, the order is, head, wheels, and then... thing. Or you could just do this. That works too. And it has lasers! Forgot about the lasers. Oh, they do a fuckload of damage. I think the US should spend more of their defense budget on making tanks that look like mythical creatures. You know, like a fucking F-16 jet in the shape of a wyvern. A tank that looks like a unicorn.
They got the dragon tank! Fix it quickly! Don't fool yourselves into thinking you've gotten away with this!
They're escaping! We have no choice but to break through!
They're escaping!
Stop! Princess Nadia. This is my friend. Show him your respect.
But...
can't you take orders? Of course! Hold it right there. Oh, that was the Chancellor. I thought that was gonna be the King. I forgot.
Do as King Guardia 33rd says!
Father.
Silence, Princess Nadia! The throne comes before your personal wishes!
What? Just because I have a title doesn't mean I'm not a person. Was it the king that said that line? I might have read that line wrong, whoops. You pick up strange ideas venturing outside. I didn't pick up anything, it's called common sense. Princess Nadia! I despise you, I'm leaving.
Princess Nadia!
Come on, Chrono.
Don't just stand there, after them!
Princess Nadia. 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 I should just say it like that so everyone's happy and no one's happy both at the same time. There's no escape. I hate to ruin the illusion of this thrilling chase scene, but... you know, you can kind of just push them around. Most ineffective soldiers. Looks like a dead end. A gate. Come on. We don't know where it'll take us. Oh shoot, that was more like a come on! Who cares? This place stinks anyway.
Princess Nadia!
This is completely irrational. Hurry, Chrono!
Princess, move away from that hoodlum! They disappeared! Ouch!
There's no way the Chancellor can reach us here. But where are we? Civilization here seems so advanced. Like we're in another world.
Got any cash?
Yes.
You call this money?
Oh, well, I have some good stuff. So, this is... Well, we'll find out in a second. Save money, it'll do you good. That's my motto.
Lao Tu Gong.
You'll find some food at Aerosdome to the northeast, but only if you get past Lab 16. The beasts there don't react to weapons like guns and swords. True Dome.
Never heard of it. This is the Tran Dome.
Kingdom? What are you talking about?
If you're looking for food, you lose.
This is an Inertron. You get a full night's sleep in a few seconds, but it still leaves you hungry. HP and MP restored, but you're still hungry. So this is the future. And it's... fucking disgusting. I'm gonna be wrapping up soon, because I have kind of a headache. That is absolutely horrible. But I want you to see what's ahead a little bit. Because it's kind of cool. So, you know, meat eaters and octopus. Oh, right, I gotta go for the meat eater first. I forgot that thing heals. Son of a bitch. It's okay, the load sword will make quick work of him. Yeah, I mean, you just turn into everyone turned into squids in the future. That's all that's left. Jesters and squids. Oh, and like, volcano things. Damn it, rat, stop stealing my shit. Those look like Octoroks. I mean, they look so much like Octoroks. They even suck my head. That's a good album name, Suck My Head. And it's just like a picture of a squid sucking a man's head. That's something like Spinal Tap would do. Or just, yeah, suck the head. Not my head, the head. Then it's a little bit more perverted, kind of.
You see, now, when we made this album, the Red Vox Suck the Head album, our thinking was that we've got to break down these barriers of language. You know what I mean, man? We've got to keep the barriers open and broken down because too many people have these preconceived notions of what sucking is. And we decided that we was going to go in a different direction. Also, Gene Simmons' Spongy Cock is one of the best songs on the album. I highly recommend you listen to it. It's a really great track. We worked hard on that one. You know, music is really, it's got the power to not only heal, but change the world, really. And the Suck the Head album has got messages of love. And
you know, political messages as well. So, you know, we're rock stars that like to share our political opinions on stage all the time, really. I mean, every time you come see a political show like ours, you know, we try to, like, make the audience feel like we feel politically. And that's the importance of rock and roll, you know, sharing our political message with the audience. And that's what we've achieved with Suck the Head, best album. I mean, who better is qualified to disseminate political information than rock stars? You know what I mean, man? You know what I mean, man? You know what I mean, man? I'm sorry, I just had a moment. I'm good. So this is the, I like to call this the tomato, thing, even though it's just called a mutant. Kind of looks like a colostomy bag made out of tomatoes. You know, Suck the Head, actually, what it refers to is not about, like, you know, squids eating heads or whatever. It's actually talking about how the political party is sucking the life out of the system, out of us. We're the head. You know, that is the art that we're trying to go for on the Suck the Head album. You know, that's the kind of thing that we're trying to, like, the concept that we're revisiting is that we're the head. And the politics, the government is sucking our head. You know what I mean? It's all of us. We're all the head. Rock. I'm back. I'm here. Never again. Don't worry. It won't happen again. That was a good slash. In the future, the sewers will spout blue slimes with faces. You know, the pollution has led us here, right? Because the politics corrupted us so much, man. That's why the future's destroyed, because we didn't take care of things. Alright, well that's good. That's not a load of bollocks, as they would say. Pollution has come to life, the year 2300. There's just a little item there. I figured, fuck it, may as well get it. Tomato Gimp. I thought we were past this. Turns out there's multiple Tomato Gimps in the future. What if they're just sad? What if it's just like the radiation and the toxicity of the atmosphere, like, just turned, like, tomatoes into sentient beings? And, like, they realize that being sentient is so much worse than just being a tomato. Because then they have to, like, worry about feelings and, like, you know, living and eating and staying alive and, like, you know, mating. And, oh, God, it's just so much to think about. Maybe being a tomato was the best time that species has ever had. And that's why they're so angry. Me
you there? Where are you from?
We came from the laboratories to the west.
What? Hey, we've got people who cross the ruins.
Say again?
You're joking. So there are people who can beat up those freaky mutants.
Who are you?
Did you really come from the dome to the west?
Yes.
See, not that I really care.
My husband went down to the food storage area below. I haven't seen him since.
Daddy's gonna bring us some food.
It's an old factory site called Protodome to the east. Can't get near it because there's a bunch of lunatic robots in the area.
You can reach the continent to the south through the sewer access, but stay off Death Peak. There's an old man living in a dome near Death Peak. Talk about crackpots.
The door with the crest. Dynamite won't budge it. Pardon me, I'm Doan. I'm the descendant of the director of this info center. In the basement, there's a huge computer and a storage center for food. But we can't get through there because of the robot guards. It's a pity. Are you going down below?
Of course.
But no one's ever returned from there.
Gotta try, right?
It's nice to see such spirited young people for a change. Careful now, come back alive.
You sure this is money? Oh well, I have to lighten my inventory anyway. Guy who walked to the other dome used to say, save money, it'll do you good. I kind of want to show you guys a little something before I stop for the night. Console controls the passageway. We need the password to get through here. So, there's a password there, but I'm gonna just, I think I could probably do this pretty quick. Wait a minute, where do you find out about... Hang on. A memo is attached to it. Warning, anyone within the vicinity of the stock room will be attacked. Forget where there's a story thing that happens that I want to really, really show the stream. I think it's coming up really, really soon. Yeah, it is, after this boss. So, got another like 10-15 minutes. I figured this would be good to show for the first stream, you know, this whole thing. Yeah, so this is the first boss that kind of gives some people a problem. I have lost to this boss before. It's kind of a bitch. But, you know. If you kill the bits,
little bits,
you get a chance to, do some damage without a whole lot of, counterattack. Well, you know, the main guardian has a bunch of attacks, but with the bits, they can get kind of nasty. Now it's gonna revive. I'm gonna try the double tech I have. See if this does any decent damage. Okay, never mind that. This one is purely physical attacks necessary. Well, what about slash? And not much better than the attacks. At least the attacks have a chance to crit. I don't know if it is possible to one-cycle this thing without doing some serious grinding. So there's the first counterattack. It kind of sucks. I hate it. I'm gonna use the Aura Whirl to get my party's HP back because fuck that. Okay, there's another one. Really great critical attacks there. Love the enemy designs in this game too. And this was a little bit later on, well, towards the end of Super Nintendo's life cycle, so... I mean, by now Squaresoft had really perfected, like, making beautiful sprites and amazing 16-bit artwork. Level up. Whew, something reeks. Everything's completely rotten. The refrigeration must have failed. Chrono, look. Passed away long ago, I suppose. It's holding something. What do you think this is? Looks like it's some kind of seed. Seed. Do you suppose it could grow in a place like this? The following is written on a soiled sheet of paper. The rat is more than just a statue. It knows the secret of this dome. Catch it. Yeah, all the food is rotten. Yes, the rat knows the secrets of the dome. Got it. Squeak, I give up! I'll tell you everything, Squeak! Press and hold the L and R buttons, then press A to access the secret passage. Squeak! Don't make any mistakes or you'll be sorry! One of the cool things about this game, not a big fan of random battles. Like, I'll play games with random battles if they're really amazing. Like, the Final Fantasy games that I enjoy. I don't mind. I'll deal with the random battles. I'll bitch about them. But in this game, you can avoid a lot of battles if you just don't want to fight them. It's as simple as that. I mean, you know, if I walk into this area, I'm gonna have to fight the blue guys, but generally, almost this whole area, you can just avoid the battles, and the game isn't so punishing that you need these battles. Like, you can do without them. Yeah, well, let's do this. You ready for this, guys? If anyone has idled out, you might want to watch this, because this is kind of cool. This is definitely a pivotal story point that I quite enjoy. So, this is the info center. Good, the computer's still operational. If we run a search on time warps, we might find our gate. Here, got it. East of Aristome. Be Protodome, I believe. Leave it to Luca. I'm beginning to think you could find anything with this device. Say, what does this button do? 1999 AD. Visual record of the Day of Lavos. What is that? Lavos, is that what's destroying our world? It must truly be in the future. No, no way. I refuse to believe it. This can't be the way the world ends. Chrono. There's only one thing we can do. We must change history, just like Chrono did when he saved me. Okay, Luca? Okay, Chrono? I guess so. It was a stroke of luck that we were sent here through that gate. Chrono, let's go. Okay. Chrono, Luca, together we can do this. Let's take a second and do some more research on Lavos's activities back in our time period. Next stop, Protodome. So yeah, the world was destroyed by that thing that just erupted from the ground and sprayed hellfire everywhere. And as you probably could see, it was definitely a lot more clean in 1999 AD. You know, before all that happened. I like how, even though they have no idea what the hell is going on or what that thing is, they still are like, fuck it, we're gonna fight it. And yeah, the theme is great. Lavos' theme is great. I mean, for anyone who's still, like, kind of on the fence about whether or not they like the story of this game, stick with it. There's some really great twists and turns, and some, I mean, just awesome character stuff, and really great, like stuff with Lavos. It's very, very interesting. But, I can tell you this, it's a parasitic life form that burrowed deep beneath the earth. To whet your appetite. Yeah, I mean, someone just said it's very, very light on good dialogue or characterization. You have to keep in mind, this game was translated from Japanese in 1995, before Square's localization team was all that amazing. Was this another Ted Woolsey game? Was it that one guy who translated it? The DS version does have better writing in some spots. In other spots, not so much. But in some, I will say there are definitely some moments in the DS version where the writing is more... the localization is definitely handled with a little bit more finesse. But I like the Super Nintendo version because it's kind of like classic. But, you know, I can see why some people would prefer the DS version. It is Ted Woolsey, yeah, it is. So, you know, one person translating an entire game. But let's see. You're back. Well, what did you discover? This is our future. Who cares? Where's the food? This is all we could get. Seeds? You don't know how long the Enertron will hold out. Those seeds might be your only hope. You have to stay alive, and so do we. Huh? You're strange. You're different from us. I think it's because we're healthy. Heel, thigh? Ah, got a nice ring to it. We'll try growing these seeds. What are those? They just might be our future. Heading for the protodome? Go by way of Laboratory 32 and take this with you. It's a key to the jet bike in Lab 32. I used to ride it when I was young. Hope it still works. They've got more powerful robots over there. Take care and stay healthy. Yeah, I mean, that's the someone in chat just said, like, how nothing you do in the future matters. And it's like, this future is fucked. You know, you don't know how long their fucking thing, the Enertron, is gonna stay around. You don't know how long these people are gonna be able to live to reproduce. Whoa, voice. You don't know what's gonna happen to them, but it's not very good. You know, and then you find out a little bit later, it's kind of worse than you thought, but that's for later. You know, it's even worse for these people than you thought. But, yeah, so that's Chrono Trigger. I hope you enjoyed the first stream of it. Like I said, I love this game, and it's gonna get, there's gonna be some really great moments. That kind of, it just kind of gradually keeps ramping things up, and it gets really great, and I can't wait to delve further into it. By my like third or fourth stream, I think you guys will really enjoy it if you've never seen it. For anyone else who knows the game, well, I just hope you enjoy the way I'm playing it. Like I said, as I go through, I'll try my best to impart some of my knowledge or whatever I do remember, because I used to go to Chrono Compendium quite a bit and just do a little research on the game and learn like people's theories and like stuff about the glitches and all kinds of stuff like that. So yeah, maybe I'll actually remember more as we go along, who knows. But I want to thank you guys for watching the stream tonight, and I have a headache, and I'm going to go to bed. But before I do that, we're going to check the art. So, yeah, hang on just a few minutes, and we'll get through it. Come on, come on, come on, get through it. Love's the greatest thing that we have. All right. From, let's see, what do we have first? Oh, this is really great. From Captain Spook. Here's me and David Bowie. Like, late 70s, early 80s David Bowie. I mean, there's just something about this that makes me happy. I don't ever wear tank tops. That's the one inaccuracy. But otherwise, Bowie looks great. You really, really, I don't know how you did it, but you kind of nailed the facial expression. And I love this. Thank you for this art. This is fantastic. I'm going to save this. It kind of makes me sad again. But it also makes me happy. I don't know how to explain it. From Pier Gaming, here's an older piece that apparently he couldn't find. Or rather, he never uploaded this to the Buru. Or maybe he did. I don't know. He's not sure either. But this is this was my old background for a little while. And I think this is great. So if you want a desktop background, head over to the Buru and check this one out. I think I like it because it kind of reminds me of Professor X's chamber in X-Men. From Redeemer 000. Here's some cool Vintroom neon 80s art. I like it. From Nutmeg Raccoon. Oh, nice. Look at that. There's a Conker's Bad Fur Day style mushroom. That's so cool. It just says cunt a lot. That's what it does. From Bajunga's Milky Dad. What am I even... I don't know what I'm supposed to be acknowledging or looking at here. I'm sorry. From Anonyma Pungent Fart. Great name. Nice art. And a BRB version. From Alec XVS. Ridiculous Snake Lady. Naga Et. It's Bulma with a bikini on, of course. From Fern321. Figured out your internet problem, Vinny. Oh, and uploading this was a pain in the dick. CAPTCHA fucking sucks. I know, it's the final boss of the internet. It's hard solving CAPTCHAs. I know. Nice art. Gotta see Deadpool now. You're making me want to see Deadpool. God damn it. Soon. I will. From Nevu Jolkheim. Goatee meme. What the fuck? Why is goatee now a meme? I never said it was a meme. I said people draw me having a goatee every now and then. God damn it. From Alec XVS. Oh God, it's me as that Zoolander lady. Holy shit. What have you done? What have you done? You're killing me. From Cuckoo Banana. Vine out. And it's just a bunch of me inside of my own head. I see the salt me, and the crazy clown me, and the sad me, which is like sponge, and then what's the one, what's the purple one? I don't know what that one is. But I love this. This is great. And I think that's it. If I missed any art, or if you had trouble uploading it to the Buru, you can just tweet your art to me, at Vinny Vinesauce, and I will see it, definitely. I just wanted to thank you all for watching. This has been a very, very cool stream for me. Like I said, not to get too sentimental, but Chrono Trigger was my first stream, and it is like a game that means a lot to me. And the music in this game was probably, you know, a big factor as to why I love music so much, and also a big factor as to why I like composing music, because this and Final Fantasy soundtracks and Secret of Mana kind of inspired me to want to write music in the first place. So, I mean, honestly, you're probably watching a game that made up a good chunk of my personality, and or if not, then kind of just speaks to that part of me that likes time traveling and frogs and sci-fi and swords. Kind of has everything. It's just one of those things that just ticks all the right boxes. So, yeah, I mean, it's going to be a lot of fun. And I hope you guys will definitely stick with it, those that have never seen it. And for everyone else, you know what to expect. You know it's going to be great. So, thank you for watching. And I just hit 30,000 followers on Twitter. And that's pretty cool. Thank you guys for that, too. It's been an amazing just, I don't know how to say, it's like kind of a shock still that I'm actually at that level for me. You know, I never expected it, but it's cool. Thank you. Much appreciated. And for everything else, I will just say, of course, if you found, there are other streamers on Vine Sauce. You can check them out tomorrow, tonight, whatever. Joel's playing Mario Teaches Typing. That's right, Mario. And Dyer's playing Bravely Second. So check them out. Check both out. And I'll host Joel tonight because I usually host Dyer. And I the way I see it is Joel doesn't need any help. Everyone knows who he is. So I kind of tend to host other people. But tonight I'm going to give Joel a host. So I want to thank you guys once again. I'm going to stop. I'm talking a lot. Despite a nasty headache, I should really stop that. But take it easy, everyone. I'll see you guys maybe tomorrow with some stuff. And wish me luck in my XComming. I'm going to need it. I'll see you later.